Porky. Let me see you swing that bat. Attaboy. You're going to be another Mickey Mantle.
Uncle Pat, who's Mickey Mantle?
Who's Mickey Mantle? Why, he's the guy that got to replace Joe DiMaggio.
Who's Joe Maggio?
Who's Joe Maggio? You talk more like your father every day. It's Joe DiMaggio, and he's one of the greatest Yankees of all time. Come on now, let me see you take another swipe at that old apple. Bopo, right out of the park, that a boy.
Hi, hey, hi. Say, what's going on, partner?
I'm swiping apples.
You're swiping apples?
He means he's taking a swipe at the old apple.
Oh, well, let me see you do it. Go on,
show him. Show your dad.
Hey, he's going to be another Joe Maggio.
I'm treating the two girls and little Ricky to the ball game this afternoon at Yankee Stadium.
Well, that's very generous of you, Uncle Pratt.
What's nothing, Rick. I'm glad to do it.
Today's Ladies' Day, Daddy.
Oh, it's Ladies' Day. Uh-huh.
Ladies and little boys getting free.
Ladies and little boys getting free.
Yeah. Just like his mother. Yadda, yadda, yadda.
Well, listen, if you're going to go to the ball game with Uncle Fred, you better go take a nap, huh?
Okay, Daddy.
You're going to sleep now, son.
Goodbye.
Here you go, Dandy.
Come on, kid, eh?
He's a dandy.
Listen, did the girl come back? Bye, partner. What are you doing dressed that night?
I'm playing doctor.
Oh, you're playing doctor, huh?
Ricky, better get out of that outfit
deal.
You know, we want to surprise Daddy, and he's
going to
be home any old dear.
Yes, oh, dear. I thought we weren't going to try to influence him. I thought we were going to let him decide for himself.
Yes, now we did say that, and he did decide for himself. This afternoon, we just happened to be in a toy store, and he took me by the hand and dragged me over to the counter and pointed to the little doctor's kit.
He dragged you.
Daddy, are you sick?
Yes, Pelican, son, yeah.
Take out your tongue and say ah.
Hey, you see, the natural-born doctor.
Come on, Daddy.
Ah.
Mm-hmm. You better have your tonsils out.
All right, I'll do that.
Come down to my office tomorrow.
Okay, I will.
Now, you know, isn't that the cutest
thing? Hey, wait, it's gone. Somebody must have taken it.
Uh-oh.
Well.
Even you, Miss United Parcel.
How was I to know that?
Come on, let's get out of the combat zone.
Well, I guess the shame is on the other foot.
Well, you did it too.
I don't care. This drum goes back first thing in the morning.
All right. So does that junior Dr. Kildare kid.
All right.
Okay.
All right. We'll all start right. From scratch.
Okay, scratch.
Okay.
Right.
All right, sir. Let me take that now, darling. You have to go back to the store in the morning.
No, Mommy.
Now, come on. Give it to Mother.
I want to play the drum.
Well, all right. I hate to admit it, but he does have a pretty good beat.
Let's go. It's a dress rehearsal, the last time we're going to do it, all the way from the top. I'm going to give you a downbeat.
Son petit menton, elle était frisée comme un mouton. Elle était frisée comme un mouton. Valentina, Valentina, quiéreme y nunca miraré a otra niña nunca más. Tra la 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 la, eres tú mi única ilusión, Valentina, Valentina. Si me dejas de querer, me partirás el corazón. Oh, 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 qué rico el vacilón. Oh, 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 qué rico el vacilón. Oh, oh.
I love you true and true, Valentina, Valentina. Love me do, please do, please do, please do, and I'll be your slave to you. Tra-la-la-la-la, life could be my darling heaven, Valentina, Valentina. Say you love me like I love you.
Little Ricky, grow up.
Isn't this a beautiful forest? The most beautiful farms I ever saw. I sure would love to live here. Wouldn't you?
I'd love to live here, too.
From 1956 to 61, Keith Thibodeau was Little Ricky. He joins us live this morning from Jackson, Mississippi, all grown up. Good morning, Keith.
Good morning.
You were actually Richard Keith, isn't that correct on the credits?
That's correct.
How old are you now?
38 years old.
You left show business at 11?
Pardon me?
Did you leave show business at 11 when I Love Lucy was over?
I stayed in for a little bit. I was on the Andy Griffith Show. I was Opie's best friend, Johnny Paul, Jason. And then my parents separated in 65 and we moved back to Louisiana.
How did you get the job of Little Ricky?
Well, I was a professional drummer at the age of 4 years old and going around the country doing one-night stands with a man called Horace Height. And I think which was like an hour before the Lucy Show. And then after that show ended, it ended up in California. Stayed at Horace's ranch there until the audition for the Isle of Lucy show came up. They were looking to expand the part of Little Ricky and make it more of a prominent role in the show. And I walked on the set and Lucy said, "That's him."
What was Lucy like to work with?
The word that comes up to me is professional, and she wanted you to be professional too, and she was just a great person to work with on the set.
Was she like your surrogate mother on the set?
Yes, she was. She took care of me, made sure that everything was right and that I was taken care of, and she was a mother.
I understand she was a terrific gift giver and very thoughtful to everyone on their special occasions like birthdays.
That's right.
What did she do?
She gave me two sets of drums. She gave me an Indian teepee because I liked Indians. She gave me a dressing room on one of my birthdays. And It was really sweet of her, that the soft side of her that she had.
How did little Desi and little Lucy treat you?